Before closing and finish the heart of this engine, we must check the compression ratio. We have here a millimeter less. We actually have a piston that it's not flat like a high performance engine, and so the squish it's not the kind of squish that you can find on very high performance two-stroke. Here the squish must be more than 1 millimeter, because also the studs are only 3. In general, this engine doesn't tolerate a lot of compression, and there it's a very basic design. Here we have the valve, the spring, the poppet valve, this clip. This is an abrasive paste, so that you will take the valve and it will be like new. Here you can see. Slightly bright, maybe slightly better, but it's just a bit, because this valve was in good condition. Okay, we have it. Now time to fill it with the water, and I will also check the volume in general. Here you can see water. I move a bit. It's more than the volume, because it's an effect of the water creating some layer up to the flat surface. But here we see no bubbles, this tool, and check how much water, because it's an information that can be useful before to close the engine. Okay, now we try to calculate the 4cc, 41.5 cc volume we found with water in the head, thinking about the shape of the piston that will influence this actual this volume. Okay, the data. You can find the formula here on the screen that I will use. So we need the total volume of the cylinder, that is 54.5, with the bore I remember, or 40.2, that we with the piston we reach. So this volume, it's intended the volume of the cylinder. We must add the volume of the chamber, and we have the total volume. So it's 44.1. This is the real volume of all the capacity of cylinder and head involved on the thermodynamic cycle. So from this we divide to the volume of only the head, and this means how much times mathematically it will fit on this number, and it's 40.1. It's awesome. It's like I think it's very much. It's 14.3. So we have very high compression, but I want something less. So I want to reach 13. Let me write it. 13.5, it's okay. This compression ratio, it's tolerable, high enough. But 14 is too much because what I think it's we also have the exhaust quite tight, and the real compression is not very much with this shape, not flat. If we have this surface that is the top of the cylinder, this part it will be up. So up, it means that will be very close to the squish area of this kind of design of lateral plug. So the best way to measure the compression ratio is to mount to assembly everything. I found this solution. I added one gasket. So we have two paper gasket like you saw in the other episode, and three original gasket. So the amount is quite big. Okay. Now we see the volume. And here we have the result. So it's really 1 cc. We can test and calculate it. The compression ratio is 11.7. Yes. Okay, it's okay. We can stay with this. And I will check the squish when everything is tied.